Mike Pence is out of his element. The pretty progressive, left-leaning streets of New York City.
It's not Vice President Mike Pence, but his colorful, out-of-the-closet doppelganger, Mike Hot Pence. Living his best life in the name of, well, anything the vice president is against.
My playbook was easy to put together because I just looked at his playbook and did the opposite.
On gay rights, on abortion, on the environment, and on wearing pants.
Yes, yes, hot pants.
He's shaking his can today as the nation's number two, but impeachment proceedings mean a possible promotion.
Right now, you are the second most powerful political impersonator in town. You could be the first.
I'm not ready to be a presidential impersonator. The thought of a Pence presidency terrifies me, and it should terrify anybody.
Well, not everybody, if you ask political observers. And we did.
He is extremely socially conservative, extremely economically conservative, and it's been a while since we've had anybody like that in the Oval Office.
Let's dissect the President Pence possibility.
How did we get here? Not the brink of a Mike Pence presidency, that's been pretty well covered.
Democrats' impeachment probe, this extraordinary Ukraine story.
Abuse of power.
The whistleblower got it all wrong!
But to the place where a Mike Pence lookalike is in front of Manhattan's Big Gay Ice Cream on National Coming Out Day.
Happy Coming Out Day.
Raising money for the Trevor Project, a nonprofit that offers crisis intervention and suicide prevention to LGBTQ youth.
I always say my mission is raising money, raising awareness, and raising Mike Pence's blood pressure.
It started with a Halloween costume a week before the 2016 election.
I saw all of the options for women, which are sexy cheerleader and sexy flight attendant and, you know, sexy calculator.
And you thought?
And I thought, how about sexy Mike Pence?
The makeup process is pretty basic. It involves the eyebrows and the hair.
The costume was a hit, but a week later, when Pence and Donald Trump won the White House, he stopped laughing. Hot Pence, whose real name is Glen Pannell, was inconsolable.
I just totally got the wind knocked out of me. I did not expect it at all. And it wasn't just a question of waking up the next morning and thinking, how could this be my president? It was waking up the next morning and thinking, how could this be my country?
He worried for LGBTQ rights, for abortion rights, for environmental protections in his community. But Pannell discovered a unique tool to respond.
My DNA.
So he took to Times Square, raising money for the most anti-Pence cause he could think of, Planned Parenthood. Thousands started following online. Then he collected for the ACLU, the Trevor Project, Everytown for Gun Safety, basically any cause he thinks the conservative vice president, and maybe one day president, would hate.
Happy National Coming Out Day. Thank you.
Safe to say, a Mike Pence presidency wouldn't look like this.
So glad to see you coming out.
But it also wouldn't look like this either.
For progressives, it would be a huge step back. I am Professor Monica McDermott, and I teach at Fordham University, and I research voting behavior. A Pence presidency would be, you would say, their worst nightmare.
It's tough to know exactly what that might look like, but we can get an idea by looking at Pence's track record as an Indiana congressman and governor.
Like President Trump, he has a long history of pro-business policies, reducing environmental protections, and favoring conservative judges. But don't expect another tweeter-in-chief. Pence prefers to do his negotiations behind the scenes. He's also more supportive than the president when it comes to American involvement in foreign conflict. And he's aggressively favored religious rights over LGBTQ and abortion rights.
What would that mean for conservatives?
Oh, they would be in heaven, especially if they still controlled the Senate.
She says Pence would be easy for the GOP to rally around if Democrats take out Trump.
I think it would energize the Republican base. For the Democratic base, it's going to be hard to generate the kind of opposition and thrill of defeat that I think Democrats are counting on at this point.
A President Pence might also help unify a Republican Party that's been a bit fractured ever since Trump came onto the scene, all the while enjoying the same huge cash advantage the GOP currently has over Democrats ahead of 2020.
For Democrats, impeachment may not be the best thing long term.
Oh, absolutely not. It's absolutely not. I think they're doing it short-sightedly. I don't think they realize what putting Pence in the White House as head of the Oval Office actually means to them for the 2020 election and for governing into the future.
Thank you for the donation.
Hot Pence says he can't wait for the vice president's final days in D.C., even though he totally feeds off the recognition.
Newfoundland, Canada.
Oh my gosh, welcome.
From liberals and conservatives.
Trump supporters come up and talk to me. Some of them come up and say, what you're doing is funny, and some of them have actually contributed. Some of them yell at me. It disappoints me now when I go out and I collect for 2 or 3 hours and nobody has screamed in my face.
Maybe New York City's not the right place.
I know, really. Hi.
I love this.
Thank you.
For now, you can still catch Hot Pence working the streets of the Big Apple, even throughout winter.
You know, I'll put on gloves and earmuffs. People have suggested tights, but that's so off-brand, so I can't do it.
And here you are.
I know, I was going to say, 3 years later. Still going strong.